Hello there and welcome back to this video series on programming for problem solving using C language. After watching this video, you'll be able to use prefix and postfix increment decrement operators correctly and specify what is side effect. We'll try to see these with the help of a sample program which is listed over here. You can see that there is additional include statement. As we go along, you will use different header files. Conavo.h is a header file, stdavo.h is a header file. This header conavo.h allows you to use CLR, SCR, clear screen function. We'll try to see what this function is and then try to use it. Essentially, you can see that this program is a series of printf statements. Don't worry about this %d and backslash n. We'll try to see what this %d format specification is and this escape sequence backslash n. But for now, see something very noticeable. Count is equal to 0 is itself an expression. This expression is embedded within a printf. Okay, such things are possible in C language. Okay, so count is equal to 0 is evaluated, and then that evaluated value is printed. Let us try to run this in our familiar Turbo C, and let us see how it comes. What is the output? It is interesting to note that. Now I am shifting to the Turbo C window. Now that we have this Turbo C window on screen, let us notice the editor window as well as the output window. In the editor window, we have the same program listed over here. Let us try to compile it and see what happened. Trying to compile it. Okay, it compiled successfully. Once it compiled successfully, I'll try to step through the program. Okay, to step through, we can press F8. Let me do that. If I press F8, the void main line is highlighted. If I press it once more, it will execute that and then go to the next statement, that is CLR SCR, clear screen. What happens? See, now you have several statements, several lines in the output screen. Once the CLR SCR is executed, all these are erased, clear screen. That is what it does. We cleared the screen. Okay, now you have this printf statement highlighted. So if you press F8, that is what will be executed now. If you see that a 0 will be printed, statement 0. 0, that is what is. Now see what happens when you again execute the highlighted statement. When you execute highlighted statement, count will be printed first and then it is incremented. Okay, now see what happens. Count is currently 0 and it is printed. Now internally its value is increased by 1. Okay, now let us execute the next statement. First count will be incremented. Current value of count will be is 1. It is incremented and now the incremented value is printed. So 2, count is already 1, it is incremented one more time. Now see what happens. Count is decremented first, currently the value of count is 2. It is decremented first and then the decremented value is printed. So 1, and again now if you execute this, you will see that statement 4, 1 is printed because it is decremented to 0 and then first it is printed and then it is decremented to 0. It may be confusing, but go through it several times. The thing you need to remember is when you use plus plus at the end of the variable is used in the current context and then its value is increased in the memory. Whereas if you use it plus plus before, first its value is incremented, then it is used in the statement. It may appear slightly confusing, but I would encourage you to go through this program, run it and try to understand. If you do not understand, do not go further than this. First understand and then go to the subject. Let us now shift to the PowerPoint presentation again. Now that we have seen execution of the program, let us come back and take a look at a couple of little points here. This is the program listed over here, and we see that while this printf is being executed, the contents of the memory count are changed here as well as here. When such a thing is happening, we say a side effect is happening. Our execution is printf statement, but along with that something else is happening. The memory location, which is named count, is accessed and its contents are changed. When such a thing happens, you call it side effect. So side effect is said to occur when a memory location is accessed or updated while some other statement is being executed. In some sense, I would not prefer to have side effect being occurring in the program. So as far as possible, do not embed any of increment decrement operators or expressions that change some other memory location into a current statement. If you want something, be explicit to avoid the side effect. For example, if you want count is equal to 0, write a separate statement, end it with a semicolon, and use the count in printf statement. Similarly, if you want to increment the count variable count, print it and then increment it. Or if you want to increment it before, insert the count in between these two statements. That is as far as possible. Do not embed increment decrement operators in between expressions or statements. Avoid the side effect. That's all for now. Have a great day.